Hello, welcome to our channel Cupid Educational Services. In this video we are going to solve the questions from the previous years of MHT CET and the topic is sequences and series. Now if you go through the syllabus of 11th and 12th standard mathematics, Maharashtra State Board, then you will find that sequences and series is a topic from 11th standard. Okay? And very recently they have started including some of the topics from 11th standard in the CET, and this is one of them, the others being the trigonometry and related chapters. Okay, second thing regarding these questions are primarily based on arithmetic and geometric progression as well as the properties of the summation notation. For example, what is the formula for the sum of first r natural numbers or first r squares of first r natural numbers and so on. Okay, these are not very difficult questions, so let us start. There are around 15 questions that I will cover in this video covering all the topics. First one, the sum of first 10 terms of the series 9 plus 99 plus 999 plus so on is 9 upon 8 into 9 to the power 10 minus 1, 100 upon 9 into 10 to the power 9 minus 1, 10 to the power 9 minus 1, and 100 upon 9 into 10 to the power 10 minus 1. Now these options or these terms in the options are an indicator that geometric progression is involved. Okay, because only in the formula for the first n terms of a geometric progression you have r to the power n minus 1. Okay, but if you look at the given series, it is definitely not in geometric progression. Okay, but what you need to do in such sums is you need to rearrange the terms. Okay, in the sense that you have to write 9 as 10 minus 1, you have to write 99 as 10 squared minus 1, you have to write 999 as 10 cubed minus 1. Okay, so if you repeat this process for the first n terms, not necessarily 10 but n terms, then it will be 10 plus 10 squared plus 10 cubed so on till 10 raised to n in the first bracket minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 n times. Okay, for example, if we consider the first 3 terms, then there will be minus 3. And in the first bracket, we will have 10 plus 10 squared plus 10 cubed. That's what you see here. But in general, if you have n terms, then the largest power of 10 will be n, and minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 n times. Okay, so minus n. And now we have got the first series here as a geometric series, isn't it? This geometric series is such that its first term is 10 and its common ratio is also equal to 10. 10, 10 squared and so on. Okay, and because we need to find the sum of first 10 terms, it will be a into r to the power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. So 10 into 10 to the power n minus 1 upon 10 minus 1. And let's not forget this. Okay, so minus n. Now we need to substitute n equal to 10. So what will S10 be? S10 will be equal to 10 into 10 to the power 10 minus 1 upon 10 minus 1 minus 10. Okay, now we have got the answer, but we need to choose the correct option. So we will now simplify this. Okay, and if you do that, it's not very difficult, mind you. Okay, you can write 10 minus 1 as 9, and then you can take 10 common from these two terms. Okay, and then take the LCM inside, so it will be 10 to the power 10 minus 1, and this 1 will become 9 now. Okay, minus 1 minus 9 is minus 10. Okay, and again take 1 power of 10 outside, so you already have first power, and after you take 10 common, you will get 10 raised to 2. Okay, so it is 10 raised to 2 upon 9. 10 raised to 2 upon 9 into 10 raised to 9 minus 1, because you took 10 common from this bracket, and this is option B, 100 upon 9, yes, into 10 to the power 9 minus 1. Now you need to be careful while picking your options, okay? Because even in option D you have 100 upon 9. However, inside the bracket here you have 10 to the power 10 minus 1, and that is not the case, okay? The case is 10 to the power 9, so option B. Next. Now what I want to tell you is this applies even to, let's say, 6 plus 66 plus 666, so on, or 1 plus 11 plus 111, and so on. So in general, this applies to any such series 1 to 9. Okay. Now, if you have anything else apart from 9, what you have to do is you have to take that particular number common, because now it is going to be the factor of all terms, like I have done here. Okay. So this can be written as 6 into bracket 1 plus 11 plus 111, and so on. Okay. And then you have to divide and multiply by 9. So if you divide by 9, then that 9 sits here. Okay. And if you multiply it by 9, then the bracket will be 9 plus 99 plus 999. Okay. So it is 6 upon 9 into the sum that we have just now found out. Okay. So this is easy if it is 9, and if you have the numbers from 1 to 8, then it is always that number upon 9 into the series that we studied just now. Okay, so please keep this extra part in your mind. This may be useful in CET. So that was the first question. Let's go to the second. Very simple. Now, as I said, you will find a lot of geometric progression questions. This says, for a GP, if Sn is 4 to the power n minus 3 to the power n upon 3 to the power n, then T2 is equal to. Okay. Now, if you know what Sn is, then it's not very difficult to solve. Okay. Sn is the sum of first n terms. Isn't it? So what I have done is I have substituted n equal to 1. So I will get the sum of first one term, that is the first term itself, okay? S1. 4 raised to 1, 4. 3 raised to 1, 3. So it will be 1 upon 3. So that is T1. Okay. Now S2, that is n equal to 2. So that is 4 squared minus 3 squared upon 3 squared. So basically, I'm replacing n by 2 in this formula. All right. Then this will be 16 minus 9, 7, 9 as it is. So this is now S2. That means this is T1 plus T2. Isn't it? But we want T2, so we need to subtract S1 from S2. Right? And if you do that, 7 upon 9 minus 1 upon 3, which we found out here, will be 7 upon 9 minus 3 upon 9 or 4 upon 9. So option A. See, there is no need to find A and R. We have indirectly solved this problem. Otherwise, we'll first find A, then find R, and then you will say, okay, T2 is AR or AR raised to 2 minus 1. But that's not necessary. Okay, if you know how to what Sn means, then you can very easily solve the question. Question 2, option A. Let's go to third one. Yes. For a geometric progression, if m plus nth term is p and m minus nth term is q, then mth term is, okay, q by p, p by q, root p q, and p q. All right. First, we write down what we have. We have m plus nth term, which is a into r raised to m plus n minus 1, assuming that first term is a and the common ratio is r. And m minus nth term is a into r to the power m minus n minus 1. Now you observe the following. In the mth term, okay, which they want us to find, there is no n. It is simply a into r to the power m minus 1. Okay, it means in order to find tm, we must get rid of n. And we can easily do that by simply multiplying p and q. Okay, so pq will be a square, yes, into r raised to, now this will be the addition of the powers. M plus n minus 1 plus m minus n minus 1 plus n minus n will go, right? So what will pq be? A square, yes, into r raised to m minus 1 plus m minus 1. So that is essentially 2 times m minus 1. Okay, so r raised to 2 into m minus 1 is r raised to m minus 1 raised to 2, because a raised to mn is a raised to n raised to m, or a raised to m raised to, okay, the law of indices. So a squared into r raised to m minus 1 squared is actually a into r raised to m minus 1 squared, but what is a into r raised to m minus 1? That is tm, isn't it, by the formula. So tm is root of pq, that is option c. Now as a homework, you may try to find tn if you can. Okay, I'll give you hint, you need to divide p by q. Okay, so the way we eliminated n here, we have to eliminate m there. Okay, so you can try this as homework. Question 3, let's go to 4th. All right, 4th question. A very simple one. If summation 2r plus 1, as r goes from 1 to n is 440, then n is equal to 21, 20, 19, 22. Okay, so this question is based on the properties of summation notation. Okay, now those who don't know these properties, if you know the properties of definite integrals, then that is the same thing that we do here, okay? All the properties, linearity, then distributive property and so on, okay? Yes. So first, what we will do is we'll use the properties and simplify this, okay? This 2 is a constant, so that will come outside the summation. And then you can just split the function and get 2 series, okay? First one is associated with 2r and the second one is associated with 1, okay? And then for the first one, take 2 outside, so it will simply be summation r as r goes from 1 to n. And this is the ready-made formula. I've told you at the beginning of our discussion, okay? All these formulas, n, n squared and n cubed, they are required. So sum of first n natural numbers is n into n plus 1 upon 2. And see, now many people don't understand this. Summation 1, how is it n? Because this number is being counted n times. Okay, so summation 1 is n. 2 gets cancelled. So it will be n into n plus 1 plus n, or n squared plus n plus n, or n squared plus 2n. Okay, and this is equal to 440. If you carefully look at the options, and it's not very difficult to see now that 440 is close to squares of all four options, in particular 21 and 20. Okay, so I have tried 20 and it has worked. N squared plus 2n is 20 squared plus 2 into 20. How much is it? 400 plus 40, so 440. Yes, so option B. Otherwise, you need to solve the quadratic equation. And that quadratic equation is n squared plus 2n minus 440 equal to 0. Okay, note that 440 is 22 into 20. Okay, and you can solve this and take the positive root. Okay, question 4 is that, let's go to 5th. If the sum of an infinite GP is 9 and sum of the first two terms is 5, than the common ratio is. Now, one thing to be noted here is, whenever they talk about infinite GP, whose sum is finite, it implies that the modulus of the common ratio must be less than 1. Okay, so clearly, B and C are ruled out. So it is either 1 upon 3 or 2 by 3. Okay, yes. Now, they are saying sum of the first two terms is 5. A plus AR is 5. Sum of all terms is 9. So A into 1 upon 1 minus R is 9. Yes, so this is the sum to infinity formula for a geometric progression whose common ratio is in between minus 1 and 1, or its modulus is less than 1. Okay, see, now they have not asked us to find the first term, they are asking us to find the common ratio. So we need to eliminate A, correct? So from the first, we will get A common 1 plus R equal to 5. And from the second, we will get A equal to 9 into 1 minus R. Okay, so what I've done is, I have used this definition of A there. Okay, so I will get 9 into 1 minus R into 1 plus R equal to 5. Use A minus B, A plus B, so 1 minus R squared equal to 5, and shift this 9 to the other side, so 5 upon 9, simplify. Shift r squared there, bring 5 by 9 to the left hand side. So r squared will be 1 minus 5 by 9 or 4 by 9. Take root, r will be plus or minus 2 by 3. Check for the options, option D. Okay, very simple problem. But you should know the formulas, that's the thing. Question 6. Was it? Yes. For a sequence Tn, okay, that means nth term is Tn. If Sn is 5 into 2 raised to n minus 1, then Tn is equal to. Now, whenever you see 2 raised to n minus 1, or in general, anything raised to n minus 1, then you need to recognize that this must be a geometric progression. Okay, so what I have done is, I have tried to write this in the standard form. Okay, Sn is 5 into 2 to the power n minus 1, and we always have r raised to n minus 1 upon r minus 1, isn't it? So I have done it, but fortunately r minus 1 is 1, or this term, okay, 2 minus 1. So this is a geometric progression with first term 5 and the common ratio 2. Simple. So what is Tn? A into r raised to n minus 1. Common ratio is 2. 2 raised to n minus 1. First term 5. So Tn will be 5 times 2 raised to n minus 1. That is option A. Okay. Let's go to 7th. Yes. Now in the 7th question, you need to be smart. Okay. So I'll tell you two methods. First method is the shortcut method, and the second method is what you will find in books. Okay. Question 7. Let's read it. If A, B, and C are the pth, the qth, and the rth terms of a geometric progression respectively, then A raised to Q minus R into B raised to R minus P into C raised to P minus Q is 0, 3, minus 1, 1. Okay. So what I have done is, because they have not said anything like A, B, C are distinct or anything of that sort. Okay. I have assumed that A equal to B equal to C. Okay. I have assumed that. Okay. And so if A is equal to B and B is equal to C, then P must be equal to Q and Q must be equal to R. Yes. And then if you go to this expression, A to the power Q minus R into B to the power R minus P into C to the power P minus Q, it will basically be A raised to 0 cube. How? Q is equal to R, R is equal to P, P is equal to Q. So all three powers will be 0, and A and B and C are equal. So it is A raised to 0 into A raised to 0 into A raised to 0. A raised to 0 is 1, 1 cube is 1. So option D. Okay, now this will save your time, correct? Make use of these loopholes given in the problem. Okay, in this case, they have not said anything about the nature of them. Okay, are they equal or are they distinct? So assume that they are equal, you'll get the answer quickly. Okay, but otherwise, if you don't know that, then you have to go to the textbook method. Okay, so you have to say, okay, A is equal to A into the common ratio raised to P minus 1. Now, don't use R because R is playing the role of index here. Okay, so I have assumed that the common ratio is m. Okay, so A is A into m to the power of P minus 1. B is A to the power, sorry, A into m to the power Q minus 1, and C is A into m to the power R minus 1, because these are the pth term, qth term, and the rth term respectively. And then you have to just put everything in this expression. Okay, A raised to Q minus R, B raised to R minus P into C raised to P minus Q. Okay, if you do that and multiply, you will find that it is A to the power Q minus R plus R minus P plus P minus Q. Okay, now let's count the powers of M. Okay, if you go to the last one, then it will be P minus Q into R minus 1, which will be equal to PR minus QR, right? Minus P plus Q. Then let's go to the second term now. M raised to R minus P into Q minus 1. So that will be QR minus PQ minus R plus P. You can check. QR, then minus PQ minus R plus P. Okay, and then what remains is this m raised to p minus 1 into q minus r pq minus rp minus q plus r, right? And eventually you will find that all of these things are getting cancelled. Plus pq minus pq minus rp plus pr minus q plus q plus r minus r plus qr minus QR plus P minus P. So M raised to 0, so 1. Okay, now let's go to this. Q minus Q minus R plus R minus P plus P. A raised to 0 into M raised to 0, 1, and that's what you had. Or that's what you had got previously, right? 1. So option D. Correct? Now I'm not saying that method 2, you should not at all follow method 2. You can follow method 2, but that is going to take you some time, or definitely more time than what it took us to get the correct option from the first method. Okay? Yes, so that is question 7. Let's go to 8th one. Value of 21 squared plus 22 squared, so on till 30 squared is. Now you definitely don't have this time to calculate the square and add. Okay? If you want, you can, but I will not recommend you doing that. Okay? What you have to do is you have to first write the given series using summation notation. Okay? Summation r squared as r goes from 21 to 30. And then you have to split this, okay, as a series of squares of first 30 natural numbers minus a series of squares of first 20 natural numbers. That will effectively give you 21 squared, so on till 30 squared. Okay, and now use the formula for summation r squared as r goes from 1 to n. That formula is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6. ओके, वी नीड टू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला टू टाइम्स. फर्स्ट एन इक्वल टू 30 एंड सेकेंडली एन इक्वल टू 20. ओके, नाउ हियर वी हैव गॉट 30 अपॉन 6 as 5, सो 5 इंटू 31 इंटू 61 विच इज 9455. नेक्स्ट, नाउ दिस इज 2 इंटू 3, दिस इज 2 इंटू 10, दिस इज 3, दिस इज 7, सो दैट विल बी 70 इंटू 41 विच इज 2870. सब्ट्रैक्ट, यू विल गेट द आंसर एज 6585, ऑप्शन सी. ओके, क्वेश्चन 8th, सिंपल, गो टू 9th. यस, नाउ अगेन दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. इफ द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड टर्म्स ऑफ अ सीक्वेंस इज 4 इंटू 3 टू द पावर एन माइनस 1, देन द सीक्वेंस इज ए पी एच पी ए जी पी एंड जी पी. अगेन 3 टू द पावर एन माइनस 1, सो इट हैज टू बी अ ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन. ओके, बट वॉट आई हैव डन इज आई हैव ऑल्सो फाउंड आउट द कॉमन रेशियो एंड द फर्स्ट टर्म. ओके, सो एस एन इज 4 इंटू 3 टू द पावर एन माइनस 1 एंड यू नो द फॉर्मूला फॉर एस एन फॉर जी पी. ओके, सो इट इज 3 रेस टू एन माइनस 1 अपॉन 3 माइनस 1 विच इज 2. ओके, एंड बिकॉज दिस 2 इज नॉट देयर इन द प्रॉब्लम, वी नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय 2, सो 4 इंटू 2 बिकम्स 8. ओके, सो दिस इज नाउ द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड टर्म्स ऑफ अ ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन हुज फर्स्ट टर्म इज 8 एंड वेल वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट इट्स कॉमन रेशियो इज 3. ओके, सो इट इज अ जी पी, ऑप्शन डी, सिंपल क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन 10th, फॉर अ ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन इफ टी एन इज 5 रेज टू एन प्लस 3 अपॉन 3 रेज टू एन प्लस 2, देन द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द कॉमन रेशियो ऑफ द जी पी आर रेस्पेक्टिवली, एंड वी हैव 4 ऑप्शन एंड इन ऑल ऑफ देम वी हैव both common ratio and the first term to be rational numbers or fractions, okay, not integers. Now what you have to do in this sum is you have only one relation with you, okay, so you try to extract the n minus 1th power. Okay, that's it. Once you do that, your job is done. Okay, and tn in our case is 5 raised to n plus 3 upon 3 raised to n plus 2. So the very first thing that I have done here is I have split the constant part and the variable part. Okay, now this allows us to get into n minus 1. So I have now modified this to 5 raised to n minus 1 upon 3 raised to n minus 1, but then that will lead to an increase in these powers by 1, isn't it? Because we have now divided by 5, so we must multiply by 5. We have divided by 3, so we must multiply by 3. Okay, so it is then 5 raised to 4 upon 3 raised to 3. Okay, and the moment we get n minus 1, we have got the common ratio, that is 5 by 3. Okay, a into r raised to n minus 1, and there is only one option whose common ratio is 5 by 3. Okay, and that is option A. But we will just verify that the first term is also correct. Fourth power of 5 is 625, square of 25. Third power of 3 is 27. It matches with the first term of option A. So it is option A. Okay, question 10. Let's go to 11th. For a geometric progression, if Sn is 7 into 3 raised to n minus 1, then the common ratio is. Now, we have already done a similar question like this, okay? You know that it is GP, but let's also quickly find its first term and its common ratio. Okay, they are actually asking us to find the common ratio. Okay, so here they have not asked us whether it is a GP or an AP, okay? Sn is given, 7 into 3 raised to n minus 1, rearrange it, okay? सो यू डिवाइड बाय टू विच इज़ एसेंशियली 3 माइनस 1 एंड मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2. ओके सो इट इज़ 14 इंटू 7 इंटू 2 इंटू 3 रेज़ टू n-1 अपॉन 3 माइनस 1. सो दिस इज इन द फॉर्म ए इंटू r रेज़ टू n-1 अपॉन r-1. येस सो ए इज़ 14 एंड आर इज 3. ओके नाउ ऑल्दो दिस क्वेश्चन इज मियरली आस्किंग अस टू फाइंड द कॉमन रेशियो. ओके यू मे एक्सपेक्ट अ स्लाइट ट्विस्ट देर. ओके सो इंस्टेड ऑफ फाइंडिंग द कॉमन रेशियो दे मे आस्क यू टू फाइंड वॉट इज द सम ऑफ द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द कॉमन रेशियो और वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सम द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द कॉमन रेशियो और वॉट इज द रेशियो ऑफ द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द कॉमन रेशियो. ओके नाउ दे कांट आस्क यू ए इन टू आर बिकॉज देन दैट विल बी टी टू. दे मे इवन आस्क यू दैट. ओके सो वॉट इज ए प्लस आर इन आवर केस 17. ए माइनस आर इज 11. ए अपॉन आर इज 14/3 एंड ए आर इज 42. ओके सो माइनर मॉडिफिकेशंस कैन बी फ्रेम्ड एज अ डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन 12. समेशन ऑफ 1 + 2 + 3 सो ऑन डेल आर एज आर गोज फ्रॉम 1 to 1. ओके नाउ यू कैन एक्चुअली सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम बाय टू मेथड्स. ओके मेथड वन एंड द मेथड टू दैट यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन. ओके नाउ द मेथड वन बेसिकली आस्क यू टू एलिमिनेट द ऑप्शंस. ओके द थिंग टू रियलाइज हियर इज दैट इफ यू लुक एट ऑप्शन ए देन दैट इज बेसिकली द सम ऑफ स्क्वेयर्स ऑफ वेल ओके नॉट नॉट स्क्वेयर्स क्यूब्स. ओके ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड नेचुरल नंबर्स. इफ यू गो टू ऑप्शन बी देन इट मस्ट बी समेशन आर एंड इफ यू गो टू ऑप्शन सी देन इट इज समेशन आर क्यूब वेल आर स्क्वेयर सॉरी. ओके नाउ नाउ ऑल थ्री ऑप्शंस ए बी सी आर डिस्टिंक्ट. ओके एंड इन पर्टिक्युलर दे आर नॉट द सेम एज समेशन 1 + 2 + 3 सो ऑन टिल आर. ओके सो ए बी सी आर क्लियरली रूल्ड आउट हेंस इट इज ऑप्शन डी. ओके इफ यू आर स्टिल नॉट कन्विंस्ड वाई द गिवन सीरीज कैन नॉट बी ए बी और सी. ओके विल गो टू मेथड टू. ओके सी द थिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर इज वी आर नॉट टेकिंग द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट आर नेचुरल नंबर्स हियर. ओके इफ द क्वेश्चन हैड बीन जस्ट दिस then yes this is indeed an n to n plus 1 upon 2 but what they have asked here is not this sum. Okay this the alternate way to represent this would be summation r as r goes from 1 to 1 but here you will see a combination of this. Okay so what they are asking us is summation 1 plus 2 plus 3 so on del r as r goes from 1 to 1. Okay, so this is different. So basically, the sum of partial sums. That's what they want. Partial sums means 1 + 1 + 2 + 1 + 2 + 3. So on till 1 + 2 till r. Okay, or till n. That's what they want. Okay, so once you get that. Then it's not very difficult to solve and I think even here itself you will realize that it has to be or it can't be a b or c so it must be d. Okay but anyways we'll solve this now by the method 2 which you will find in the standard books. Summation of 1 plus 2 plus 3 so on del r. So first we will write down this series in terms of summation. So here I am taking the summing variable as j. Okay, so summation j as j goes from 1 to r is essentially 1 plus 2 plus 3 till r. Okay, so what is the formula for summation of first sum of first j natural numbers? J into j plus 1 upon 2. So here it is sum of first r natural numbers. So r into r plus 1 upon 2 and this is the function, okay, whose sum needs to be taken as r goes from 1 to n. Okay, take this 2 outside. So it will be r squared plus r inside the summation. Yes. Now what is summation r squared? If you don't remember the formula, करेक्टली, यू कैन टेक द हेल्प ऑफ ऑप्शन सी. ओके, एन इन टू एन प्लस वन इन टू टू एन प्लस वन अपॉन सिक्स फॉर स्क्वायर्स. ओके, एंड देन प्लस आर, वी हैव ऑलरेडी यूज दैट. एन इन टू एन प्लस वन अपॉन टू, यस. सिंप्लीफाई, टेक एन कॉमन, वन अपॉन सिक्स कॉमन एंड एन प्लस वन कॉमन. नाउ हियर एक्चुअली यू डोंट हैव सिक्स, सो मल्टीप्लाई बाय सिक्स एंड देयर गोज सिक्स इन द न्यूमरेटर. ओके, सो इट विल बी थ्री इन द न्यूमरेटर आफ्टर यू टेक सिक्स कॉमन. ओके, सो वन अपॉन टू यू ऑलरेडी हैड इट, देन वन अपॉन सिक्स इन टू एन इन टू एन प्लस वन. सो फर्स्ट टर्म इन साइड द ब्रैकेट इज गोइंग टू बी टू एन प्लस वन एंड द सेकेंड टर्म एज आई एक्सप्लेन इज गोइंग टू बी थ्री. ओके, एंड देन यू कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस, वन अपॉन टू इंटू वन अपॉन सिक्स इन टू एन प्लस वन एज इट इज. टू एन प्लस वन प्लस थ्री विल बी टू एन प्लस फोर, टेक टू कॉमन इट विल बी एन प्लस टू. सो दिस टू विल कैंसल दिस टू एंड यू विल गेट एन इन टू एन प्लस वन इन टू एन प्लस टू अपॉन सिक्स. ओके, एंड दैट्स एग्जैक्टली वॉट वी हैड गॉट बाय द एलिमिनेशन मेथड, ऑप्शन डी. करेक्ट, स्लाइटली ट्रिकी प्रॉब्लम बट नॉट वेरी डिफिकल्ट, राइट? क्वेश्चन 12. लेट्स नाउ गो टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन. अगेन इन क्वेश्चन 13 आई हैव यूज्ड द एलिमिनेशन मेथड. इनफैक्ट आई हैव ट्राइड ऑल द ऑप्शंस, दैट्स इट. लेट्स रीड इट. इफ द थ्री नंबर्स 13 प्लस एक्स, 15 प्लस एक्स, 19 प्लस एक्स आर इन हार्मोनिक प्रोग्रेशन, the first and the only question on harmonic progression, then x is equal to minus 7, minus 6, 6, 7. Okay, now you should understand that whenever any numbers, let's say a, b, c, r, n, a, p, then their reciprocals are in hp. Here we have 13 plus x, 15 plus x, 19 plus x in hp. So their reciprocals must be in ap. Which means, okay, the middle term 1 upon 15 plus x should be the arithmetic mean of the first and the third. Yes, so you can see 1 upon 13 plus x plus 1 upon 19 plus x by 2 or into 1 upon 2. Okay, first I have shifted 2 to the other side and I have got this relation or equation in x. Now if you cross multiply and solve, you will get the answer. But what I have done is I have started with option A and I have checked whether substituting x as 7 gives us the correct relation. Okay, so if you substitute x equal to negative 7 here, it will give you 2 upon 15 minus 7 or 2 upon 8 or 1 upon 4. So that is the LHS. So if we get RHS equal to 1 upon 4, we are done. Okay, what is RHS now? 1 upon 13 minus 7, which is 1 upon 6. Then 1 upon 19 minus 7, which is 1 upon 12. 1 upon 6 is 2 upon 12, add 3 by 12 or 1 upon 4. So did you get LHS equal to RHS? Yes. And hence it is option A, because in CET only one option is correct. Okay, so now we have solved 13 questions from previous years. The only topic on which there was not a single question, well, there are two of them. Topic number one, arithmetico-geometric progression. And topic number two, infinite series that you have at the end of this chapter. Like the function e to the power x has this power series expansion. You also have the power series expansion for sine x. And cos x and log of 1 plus x and so on. Okay. So you may expect a question in this year's CET based on arithmetico-geometric progression or infinite series. Okay. If you continue, well, if you believe that they will not go into such great detail, then you can focus more on APGP, HP, and the properties of summation notation. But I think you should also cover AGP and infinite series, okay? So that you will have an upper edge over other candidates who will be writing CET. Okay? So that is the end of previous year's questions on sequences and series from MHTCET. Okay? I thank you all for subscribing to my channel, and I encourage you to share our channel with your friends so that they will also get benefited from what we share on our platform. Thank you.